Welcome back to AI Model Optimization with Intel Neural Compressor. Mixed precision is the simplest way to speed up both training and inference. It's used pretty widely in training today's large models. But the focus of this series is on model optimization for inference. So what kind of inference benefits can you get, and what is the effort required? As the name implies, this technique mixes numeric formats using smaller types where it can. Previous videos in this series have covered the benefits and challenges of quantizing to int8. These 16-bit formats are just smaller floating-point formats, so they're easier to mix in. Float16, otherwise known as half-precision floating-point, maintains much of the precision and some of the dynamic range of 32-bit. Bfloat16 has the advantage of maintaining the same dynamic range as FP32, but a smaller amount of the precision. So choosing between these depends on the needs of the model. And some devices only support FP16, whereas more modern devices and instruction sets, such as Intel AVX 512 or Intel AMX, have optimization specifically for Bfloat16. Finally, certain layer types may not be numerically stable with lower precision. Wait, didn't I say mixed precision was simple? Fortunately, Intel Neural Compressor automates things, no matter what framework you're using. Let's take a look at an example. There's a link to this example in the description. It shows int8 quantization on a 4th-gen Intel Xeon scalable processor, but I'll modify it to just use mixed precision instead of int8. I'm accessing a 4th-gen Xeon node on Intel Developer Cloud, because Intel Neural Compressor will look at what instruction sets are available and automatically use appropriate data types. It has AVX 512 and AMX, so Bfloat16 is supported. I've already run training, which only took a couple minutes because this is just an example. I'll run quantization while I show you the changes I made for mixed precision. Like the other quantization methods in Intel Neural Compressor, you configure it and call the fit function. This uses the default configuration. The documentation shows all the config options, a key one being the precision type. Bfloat16 is default, so that's what gets used here. For the fit function, you specify the model in the config. That's really all you need, and Intel Neural Compressor will automatically choose the data types supported by your model's layers and by the device you're running on. But I also specified an eval data loader and metric. Just like with int8 quantization, Intel Neural Compressor can use these to compute the accuracy of the reduced precision model and automatically back off conversions of layers that have too much negative impact on accuracy. This automates convergence on your accuracy goals. Now it's done, and it was able to convert everything to Bfloat16 and meet the accuracy goals. And looking at the size of the models, note that I didn't bother changing the output model name from int8. This is the mixed precision output. It's just a bit more than half the size. Now, comparing the inference times between the FP32 and the mixed precision model, we can see some significant speed up. So this was a pretty simple way to speed up inference and reduce model size without having to sacrifice any accuracy. The best way to get started with mixed precision in Intel Neural Compressor is its landing page, which is linked in the description or here with the QR code. And don't forget to check out the other videos in the AI Model Optimization series.